In 1998, Samantha Meisher executed her most ambitious and resolved project. Titled Constructions, the central elements are photographic images of a woman's naked body. In fact, it was the artist's own. The body emerged from darkness, and it was overlaid with photographs of dress patterns. These photographs were then toned and bleached with a process called Mordansage. Mordansage chemically includes a bleach component, cupric chloride, that bleaches out the tonality of the silver. It also contains a degenerative component, hydrogen peroxide, that dissolves the organic gelatin bond. It thereby releases the silver from the dark areas of the prints, leaving the paper base exposed. Maeshiro then sewed onto the prints with black thread. The stitching was never ornamental. Using only the utilitarian and provisional running stitch, it was placed to suggest that the subject of the images was doing the sewing, sometimes pulling the pattern pieces together and other times onto her own body. Maeshiro wrote that this work explored, quote, construction and decay, and the way things are simultaneously built and destroyed, unquote. Constructions is a powerful commentary on female agency. If one is to understand the dress patterns as a metaphor of social construction, the subject uses them in ways not originally intended. She uses them instead to build and to suit herself. However, due to the decayed surfaces of the print and the placement of stitches directly onto her body, one perceives that the subject's journey towards selfhood is not one taken without struggle or pain. In December of 1999, just 2 weeks prior to Maeshiro's death, she executed another artwork that seems to explore similar issues. It had no title that I'm aware of. It was a small white paper box labeled Art. It housed a dress literally and completely taken apart at the seams. Along with the pieces of fabric, the box also contained a small envelope labeled Notions. The envelope held buttons, snaps, and hooks. In describing this work, Maeshiro evidently conveyed that the dress was a favorite, but that she didn't need it any longer. She also mentioned that all the pieces were still there if anyone wanted to put it back together again. On December 15, 1999, at approximately 10 in the morning, Samantha Maeshiro chose to end her own life. She did it by ingesting cupric chloride, the bleaching agent of Mordansage. It is suspected that her death took longer and was more painful than she had anticipated. She had left no note. Samantha Maeshiro. She touched many in her 25 years among us. Those of us who knew her recognized that no single reason drove her to end her life. She was far too complex a mind and far too rich a spirit. In her life or death, as in her art, she left many questions unanswered. Not for laziness, no lack of serious consideration on the part of the author. Her open-ended questions leave us with a great thirst and an even greater curiosity. She leaves us with a notion that clues and mysteries are to be found in life's every detail. On the day before her suicide, Sam told me that she wanted to go to Poland. She said that she had just finished a really strange book, that she wanted to go to the place that would generate such an odd vision. The book is Memoirs Found in a Bathtub by Stanislaw Lem. I found the following excerpt on the second to the last page. It goes like this. Quote, he had to do it, of course. This was absolutely the only way to convince me that he hadn't lied. Words, entreaties, threats wouldn't have helped. He was presenting me with the one irrefutable proof. I looked around, the clothes lay under the sink, carefully folded. Apparently, he hadn't wished to bloody them. Had he left some sign, some message, a last will and testament, or a warning, anything written, I would have my doubts again. This he knew and so left only a naked body, as if to say by the very nakedness of death that not everything was false, that there was, in the final analysis, something absolute and something unmistakable, something that no amount of subterfuge could ever alter. He died then, for my sake, and in so doing, saved himself.